you should remember is this one, the length between the perpendicular, which we call it LBP, or sometimes it is also called as LPP, length between the perpendicular. Now, okay. Now, what is LBP is? It is the length between the two perpendicular. Which two perpendicular? One is forward perpendicular and one is aft perpendicular, right? Remember,
Yes, sir.
length
Yes,
perpendicular is the length between the two
sir.
perpendicular. One is forward perpendicular, one is aft perpendicular. Now the question is, where is this forward perpendicular and where is this aft perpendicular? So that what we consider is, we consider my ship is floating in the loaded condition, that is fully loaded condition. Okay. Now this waterline is design load waterline, right? Wherever this water is intersecting the ship's hull, this point, I'm taking one perpendicular from this, right? For, see, I'm not taking for any waterline, I'm taking only for load waterline. So wherever this waterline is intersecting ship's body, I'm taking the perpendicular. Why I'm saying perpendicular? It is perpendicular to the water surface, right? So this perpendicular, now this perpendicular is a, called as FP. FP stand for forward perpendicular, right? And where is the aft perpendicular? At aft, you are having rudder, right? And rudder, you are having one, there is something called a rudder stock, right? So the line which is taking from the center line of the rudder stock, not rudder, center line of the rudder. I'll write it over here. Center line of rudder stock. Okay. This is the center line of the rudder stock. Now, this perpendicular is called as aft perpendicular. Okay. So, length between these is the length between the perpendicular. Everybody is remember this? We already discussed in the second
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
semester. So LBP is the length between the perpendicular, that is length between the forward perpendicular and aft perpendicular. Where is this forward perpendicular? Wherever water load water line is intersecting the ship's body, we are taking one perpendicular from there. And at aft, we are taking the perpendicular from the center line of the rudder stock. I have written over here. So this is the length between this is the between the perpendicular. Now if you see, I have shown somewhere something called midship over here. Right, so where is midship exactly? Midship is exactly, I'll show different color. Midship is exactly this one, that is half of the length between the perpendicular is your midship. Understand what I'm saying? So from here to here, it is LBP divided by 2. From here to here, it is LBP divided by 2. Am I correct? Understood what I have done? Midship, what I have shown. See, so LBP divided by 2 and LBP half of the LBP is your exactly is your midship. See, so midship, I am not considering to length between the what I mean to say, like length at water level, overall length, but midship we always consider from the mid of the length between the perpendicular. That's why I written LBP divided by 2 till here and LBP divided by 2 till here. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
Right. So now
Yes, sir.
I'll take some reference. Okay. Now there are some reference points I will show you, because in problems we are using some alphabets, so it should not be confusing. So what are these reference points? Okay. Okay. Now this is my. Okay. Now this is my forward perpendicular. This is my aft perpendicular, and this is my midship. I'll show in different colors, right? Better. Right. So this is my midship. This is my forward perpendicular. We denote with FP. Aft perpendicular. We denote with the AP. Right? So this is the theory. See, I'm not showing the rudder stock, waterline, anything. I'm only showing you the reference point. Okay? So this is a three line. Now, the alphabet what we are using, For forward perpendicular, we use the alphabet F. The midship, we use the alphabet H. Okay, and after perpendicular, we use the alphabet A. It is very simple. The midship we always denote with the H, the forward perpendicular with the F, and the aft perpendicular with the A. Now, why I am telling you this? Just remember this. Okay. There is one point called center of gravity. Anybody can tell me what is the center of gravity? G. What is center of gravity? This is normal physics.
It's the point at which any object can be
turned. Stephen.
And the total mass of the object.
Total mass of the ship is considered.
Okay. We are going to come. This is a very big chapter. Center of gravity in the stability. We'll study that. But in simple, I can say it is where my centroid, right? Or it is a point at which I can balance the object. Or it is a point at which entire mass is concentrated. So we denote with the G. Then there is one more point called center of buoyancy. Both things we are going to study because these are the entire chapter. So why I'm telling you this now is only to understand, like, why this reference point is given. Okay. Now understand. Now, sometimes in question, the question is saying, find FG. Just understand. Sometimes they say find HG. Sometimes they say find AG. Okay, or they may say find. Yes.
Sir, the video is loading, sir. It's not coming.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Stephen, sir.
Now it's coming, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Now it's coming.
Okay. Now it's easy. People don't use wrong words.
Sorry, sir.
Okay, find FG, HG, or AG, or sometimes they may say find FB, HB, or AB. Okay, so this is sometimes the question makes come. So that time you should understand, like, what is the meaning of find FG? FG means G stand for center of gravity, F stand for forward perpendicular, right? That means find FG means find the center of gravity with respect to forward perpendicular. Now, what is the meaning of with respect to means? Where is my center of gravity location?
Midship, sir.
Yeah, not midship. No, I'm just showing you. Somewhere, suppose it is over this position. The star what I show. The question may be find FG means where is my center of gravity point from forward perpendicular. So what may be this distance they are asking? Understood what I'm saying? The second question may be find HG means what? Find the center of gravity with respect to H means what? Midship.
Midship.
Right? So they are asking actually this distance. Understand what I'm showing you. They are asking you only this distance. Okay. Now, third question is find AG. AG means what? Find the center of gravity with respect to A. A stand for? Half perpendicular. Right?
Half perpendicular.
Yeah. So they are asking actually this distance. Understood what is the difference between all these three?
Yes.
They are asking find the center of gravity point with respect to either forward perpendicular or midship or aft perpendicular. Understood? What is FG, HG, AG? Okay.
Yes, sir.
The same way. Yes. Same way, there may be point called central buoyancy over here. The star, what blue star, what I showed. If they say find FB, what will be the meaning of this?
Forward beam.
Yes. Find center of buoyancy point with respect to forward perpendicular. Find HB means what? Find the center of buoyancy location with respect to the midship. Right? And find AB means what? Where is my center of buoyancy with respect to half perpendicular? Now it is clear, these points?
Yes.
All these three?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. What is the only reference point? So best thing you should understand, there are three points. One is F, one is H, what is A? A stand for half perpendicular, S stand for midship, and F stand for forward perpendicular. And whatever point, I am just saying G and B as a center of gravity and center of buoyancy point, but if whatever they are asking, they will ask with respect to this point. For example, if I ask you, where is your midpoint of your class? For example, can you tell me without telling you the reference? Reference means you have to tell, right? It is 2 meters away from the blackboard, or it is 2 meters away from the door, right? So some reference point you should give. You simply cannot say 2 meters, 3 meters. No, some reference point you have to give. Now this A, H and F are your reference point. Understood what I mean to say?
Yes, sir.
Okay. One more example I can say, suppose in your hostel room, that one table is there at the middle. So you cannot say table is at 3 meters. Can you say that? No, I cannot say that. I should say it is 3 meters away from the window, or 6 meters away from the door, right? Something like that. You should give some reference. Now these reference are A, H and F. That is half perpendicular, midship and forward perpendicular, right? We'll go for the next. The next, the very important, okay. One more reference I'll give you. I'll just use. Can you see my screen?
Hello, sir.
No, sir.
I have.
No, sir.
Wait.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, this.
Sir, I came by 3:20.
Oh. All this attendance thing, just tell me on separately, not in the class.
Okay.
Now you can see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, which section is this? What view is this?
Transverse.
Now, this is the longitudinal view, right? And this is the transverse view. Now suppose I am having the center of gravity point somewhere over here, right? So I have to give some from the side. I don't have to give because my ship is symmetric from port and starboard, so I don't have to give from the side. But vertically, I have to give from somewhere, right? So vertically, we give either I can give from the deck or either give from the bottom. Bottom, it is called as keel. So I denote it with K. Understood what I'm saying? So yes, I can say, yeah. So I can say, suppose this point is center of gravity. So this is my KG. KG, what is the reference of KG? It is a vertical distance of center of gravity. Very simple. K is just a reference point in a vertical direction, I'm saying. Okay, so this is one reference. All these things are just a reference. Just understand this. When we'll do the problem, you'll understand. K is a reference from the bottom we are taking. Either C, this reference I can take from the deck or bottom. So I'm taking from the bottom. Bottom, I'm naming it as K. So KG will be there. Okay, so these are some reference points. Then we'll go with the new one. We are starting the new chapter. Not new chapter, actually first chapter. That is, the chapter name is Center of Gravity. We denote the center of gravity with the alphabet G. Okay, so this is our first. So till now what we have done is just some basic concept. So today what we have started is the chapter called Center of Gravity. Okay, now what is center of gravity? Center of gravity, it is a point at which entire mass is concentrated. okay, or I can say the center of gravity, it is a point where I can balance the object, right? So this is the basic definition you might have already studied in the physics, right? Now center of gravity, I can say, for example, suppose I am having the object rectangle, exactly the rectangle. Where will be the my center of gravity point? It will be exactly at the center of this. Right? It will be exactly at the center of point G. This point, I am naming it as point G. Okay. Suppose it is a circular section somewhere over here. I'll denote it with G. Right? The third section I can show is random section. For example, it is something like this. Where will be my center of gravity? Exactly, can you tell me?
No, sir.
No, sir.
You cannot. But can it be at this position or this position or this position? Like I'm naming it as A, point B, point C. Where it can be?
C. C.
Yeah, mostly. Yeah, my center of gravity will be at the C position. Right? What is the reason? If you see the figure itself, I am at near the C, there is more mass over here. So my center of gravity will be where I am having more mass, my center of gravity will be at that point. Understood?
Yes.
Where point A and point B, my mass is very, very less. So center of gravity cannot be at this point. But my center of gravity will be at near C, somewhere near C. Right? So what I can say from these figures is my center of gravity is totally depend upon the mass. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes.
So first thing what we are discussing, my center of gravity is, it is a point at which my entire mass is concentrated, or it is a point at which I can balance the object. And second thing what we can say about center of gravity is, my center of gravity is totally depend upon the mass. So first thing I will write is totally depend upon the mass. This is a very important point. Okay. The third point is, my center of gravity, how it is acting? Upwards, downwards, sidewards. Well, how my center of gravity is acting?
Downwards.
If you keep downwards. My center of gravity always act downwards. Okay. My center of gravity is always acting downwards. Now the meaning of the downwards is, now you can tell me, the downward can be in the incline also. For example, if I show you the arrow, my downwards can be in this position, my downward can be in this position, right? But my center of gravity always act in this position. Now what is the meaning of this? My center of gravity always act vertically downwards. Am I clear?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
See, sir. Downward can be, can you see this dotted arrow? Can you see this dotted arrow?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So what is the meaning of this? Even this is downwards, but my center of gravity is always acting vertically downwards, vertical to the ground of the earth, right? Always perpendicular to the ground. So my center of gravity is always acting vertically downwards. This is also one more important point. Now other important points about center of gravity is, now, suppose I am having one object. For example, I am having one, one ball. Okay. Where will be the center of gravity? It will be exactly at the center of that ball, right? Suppose the same ball is placed in the water. If I put it in the swimming pool, will my center of gravity change?
Yes, sir.
No.
Center of gravity, no, sir. No, sir.
So what?
Okay. So what I'm saying is, if I'm having any object, suppose I'm having the pen. Okay. Yeah. The center of gravity will be somewhere at the middle of that pen. Now what I'm doing, I'm taking that pen and I'm putting in the water. Okay. So will my center of gravity of that pen will change?
Okay. No, sir. No, no.
No, sir.
Okay. My center of gravity of any object will never change until and unless I modify that object. Modify means what? Until and unless, if if I add some mass to that pen or if I remove some mass from that pen, the center of gravity will never change. Whether you put it in the water or whether you put it anywhere, whether you put it in the like oil also, my center of gravity will never change. For example, now this, I'm having one pen over here, right? Everybody can see this pen?
Yes.
My center of gravity will be somewhere at where I'm holding it, right? The same pen, if I put it in the water, my center of gravity will not change. Okay. But suppose the same pen, if I incline, that time also my center of gravity will not change. Incline in any angle, my center of gravity remains at the same point. Okay. But suppose if I add some mass to it, suppose I added some mass, if I added some weight to it, now my center of gravity may shift wherever, depend upon where I'm adding the mass. Or if I remove, for example, if I remove this... Hema Chandru.
Sorry, sir.
Just turn off your mic. Okay. See, what I was saying is, suppose until and unless if I add some mass to this pen, okay, my center of gravity will not change. Or if I, or other way, if I remove this, for example, this back portion, if I remove it, then also my center of gravity will change. So the main point is my center of gravity will never change until and unless if I modify that object. Modify means what? If I add some mass to it, or if I, or remove some mass from that object. Understood? Very simple. So it, but it is the same as the first one. It's totally depend upon the mass, right? If I add some mass or subtract the mass or shift the mass, then my center of gravity will change. Regarding the ship, I can give the example like, suppose I'm having the ship. Okay. Now, suppose my ship's center of gravity is somewhere at the midship, for example. I'll show you the same ship. Okay. So, suppose my center of gravity is somewhere at the midship. Right now, my ship is newly built, so it is on the land, right? Suppose the same ship, if I put in the water, my center of gravity will change.
No,
my center of gravity will not change whether my ship is on the land or whether ship is in the water. Second thing, now what happens is I have loaded the cargo in the ship. Now, will my center of gravity change?
Yes, sir.
If I loaded some cargo in the ship, then my center of gravity will change. Or, other words, suppose I remove the fuel from the ship, will my center of gravity change?
Yes, if I remove fuel.
Yes, my center of gravity will change because I removed the weight from it. Or other example I can say, suppose I am having some generator in the engine room. If I shift that generator from the aft to the forepeak tank, will my center of gravity change?
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
No. It yes, will sir. Change. Yes. I have shifted the mass. I am playing with the mass. Playing in the sense means what? If I add the mass, if I remove the mass, or if I shift the mass, my center of gravity point will always change. Very simple. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, so what the point we have discussed is center of gravity is the point at which the entire mass is concentrated. Second point is my center of gravity totally depend upon the mass. That means what? If I add the mass, or if I remove the mass, or if I shift the mass, my center of gravity of that object will change. Third point, what we discuss is my center of gravity always act vertically downwards. I am not saying downwards because downwards can be in any angle. I am saying vertically downwards.
Vertically,
right? Downwards. These are the point we should understand, a basic point about the center of gravity. Okay. Now we will discuss how much. What is the time? 40. Still 5 minutes are there. I'll just tell you the basic thing. Now, as per your syllabus and what you should know, my center of gravity. Shift in center of gravity. This is the topic. What is the meaning of shift in center of gravity? Means, suppose if I add the mass, or if I remove the mass, or if I shift the mass, at which point my center of gravity is moving. This is our topic. So basically, we are having only three factors. One is adding the mass. One is removing the mass. And third one is adding mass, removing, one is shifting the mass. Okay, this is the main topic what you have to study. In simple words, see where it is going, how it is going, at what distance it is going. This is our syllabus which we will discuss in the next class. But I'll tell you like what exactly is happening in very brief. Suppose this is my ship. Okay, and right now this point is my center of gravity point G. Now when my ship is on the land, okay. Right now my ship is on the land. I take the ship, I put it in the water. The center of gravity will remain at the same point. Now what I have done is I have added some mass to it. I added a cargo to this. Then what will happen? My center of gravity will shift. Yes or no? Same? It will change.
It will change.
Second thing what I have done, I have removed some, for example, suppose I remove the anchor from here. Here I added the mass. Okay, here I remove the anchor. Then also my center of gravity will change. Yes? So the G will again shift from this star position. And third one is, suppose I am having some oil over here. I have taken it in the front over here. Then also my G position will change. So what I have done? If I added the mass, if I remove the mass, and if I shift the mass, in these three conditions, my center of gravity position is going to change. How much it is going to change and where it is going to change, this is the topic. Okay. Now this topic, what we are going to do is we are going to study in the next class.